Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. We are from group 2 and we want to presentation about disease control of coffee and clove plants. Next, first, let me introduce our member. My name is Nur Hovifa with study number 59, Fujianti with study number 62, Anissa Rikawati with study number 168, Desti Dwi Artanti with study number 233, Luhung Dharma Bakti with study number 188, and Ilham Faiza with study number 239. Next, the first background, coffee. In people, coffee plantation, namely low productivity and quality that does not meet export standard. The low productivity of coffee and is partly caused by the attack of plant destruction organism. Next, clove. Obstacles that are often encountered in the cultivation of clove are pest and disease attacks. Pest and disease attacks greatly affect the production of clove plants. Next. The next is coffee plant disease. Coffee plant has a high economic value among other plantation crop and plays an important role as a source of foreign exchange, source of income for no less than 1.5 million coffee farmers in Indonesia. The low productivity of coffee is caused, among other, by attack by plant pest organism. Next, rust of coffee leaf. Classification, Hemileia vasta trick. Spread of this stroke, your the spurs which can be formed throughout the year. The development of this is influenced by humidity. Ripe spore can be spread by the wind and form germination. Water droplets containing air are required. Symptom of the plant being attacked, the disease leaf appear yellow spot, then turn brown. The surface of the spot on the underside of the leaf is orange or orange powdery are the spores. On heavy attack, the tree looks yellowish. The leaf file, finally, the tree becomes white.
Okay, the next is coffee leaf rust disease control. There are four ways to control leaf rust in coffee, namely one, a use tolerant varieties, two, biological control using verticillium fungi, and the next, chemical control using pesticide, and the next, improving cultivation systems. Okay, next is coffee leaf spot disease, species coffee cola. This disease is caused by fungus coffee cola, which can appear in nurseries to mature plants and attack coffee carriers. This is a leaf develop yellow spot was it are surrounded by a yellow halo circle. This disease generally found in plants that are poorly maintained. The spread of disease is aided by humid environment and poor cropping pattern. The spread of disease through spores carried by wind and rainwater flow and agricultural tools. The next, the affected fruit develop a brown spot, usually on side that receive more sunlight. This spot root and can get to the seed, reducing the quality. Next. Coffee leaf spot disease control. First effort to control spot disease in nurseries include reducing humidity by reducing the same in the nursery gradually according to the age and seedling, thinning the seeds according to age, reducing the intensity of speech, improving drainage in the nursery environment, and improving to air circulation in the nursery area as best as possible. If symptoms of leaf spot attack are found and it has not spread, then the affected or sick leaves are cut. The sick leaves, either fallen or cut, are the collected and burned. Praying fungicides made from active copper or with fungicides made from mancozeb active ingredient. Next, control in the area of the coffee plant, especially the affected fruit, can be prevented with adequate shading arrangement and affected fruit immediately, because generally the fruit affected by leaf spot can easily fall off due to the unhealthy condition of the fruits.
Okay, and the next is fungus disease. This fungus is spread by blowing wine on by splashing water. Humid condition and lack of sunlight are very helpful for the development of this disease. A fungus can attack the stem, grains, twig, and fruit of coffee. This fungal infection first occurs on the other side of a branch or twig. The attack began with the presence of sling-like cobweb spread fungal threads. Furthermore, in that part, there is necrosis and then rot so that the color becomes dark brown or black. Necrosis of the fruit starts from the base of the fruit around the stalk, then extend to the entire surface and reach the endosperma. Next. Fungus disease in coffee plants control. First, how to control upas fungal disease in this plant that can be done by regularly trimming the seed. The goal is that the humidity in the coffee plantation area is reduced so that it will reduce the rate of development of upas fungi. In addition, if the affected branch is still small in size, then cut it at the bottom of the affected base, then collect it and destroy it by burning it. And then if the disease is still in its early stage, it can be controlled by smearing the fungicide calixin RM. And then well at an affected level of attack, the disease branch or stem are cut, then the rest of the cut stem of branch and their surrounding were smeared with the fungicide calixin RM or copper sandose. Next. Okay, the next is rot disease, brown, black, and white. A symptom of the plants being attacked by yellowish green leaf color, dull, wilt, and hanging. The wool leaf turn yellow, then wither simultaneously, eventually dying out on the branch. Typical symptom of brown rot fungus, especially in the taproot covered by a cast consisting of grains of soil that are firmly attacked. Among the soil grains, a blackish brown mushroom thread was visible. Disease rot would dry and soft. Typical symptom of black rot fungus at the base of the stem and the surface of the root with their black dot. The white root fungus on the root surface contain the fungal threads running along the roots and at the end extending like feathers. Disease spread and progress more rapidly in sandy and moist soils. Next.
Selanjutnya yaitu ada coffee root disease control. Control of coffee root disease can be done by breaking the affected tree down to its roots, then burning it. The hole was left open for 1 year. Healthy trees, around 6 trees, and other trees sprinkled with Trichoderma, 200 gram or per tree, and manure or organic fertilizer. Keep it every 6 months until the area is free of root fungus. Next. Chapter 2, clove plant disease. Clove plant. Cloves are Cygnium aromaticum L. Mer and Perry is one among species which has been used for a long time in Kretek cigarette. Used for a long time for Kretek cigarette. Food, beverage, and pharmacy industry. Parts of three which are used for the above purpose are cloves, bud, stem, and leaf. The obstacle that there are often encountered in cloves cultivation are pests and disease. Pest attack can result in disturbed plants, crops, decreased production, and even death of plants. Root rot disease. Disease caused by fungi such as Pythium, Rhizoconia, Phytophthora usually attack during the first critical period of the clove plant. The visible symptoms are yellowing of the leaves, wilting, and then drying out, and if the plant is removed, rotting root will appear. The recommendation for overcoming this disease are technically the plants are removed and then burned so that they do not spread to other plants. Where's chemically burned after the after plants are removed and burned. The plants around the six plants are sprayed using copperoxychloride 0.5% or every 5 grams dissolved in 1 liter of water.
Okay, the next one is leaf disease. The fungi Chlorosporium piperantum and Cylindrocalyptum unique substratum are the cause of this disease. Leaf disease appears at the time and sending at the beginning of the planting due to the fact that the plant's cover is too thick, causing the plant to be hemorrhaged. Symptoms due to the attack of the fungus Chlorosporium piperantum, namely the old leaves, appear brownish yellow spots. This fungus can spread to the wind, while the symptoms caused by Cylindrocalyptum attack are red brown spot on the leaves. While in the middle of the leaves are white, the attack is very fast by damaging the shoot and stalks. Suggestions in overcoming this disease is to thin the protective nursery, and because this disease can be carried away by strong wind, it is better to spray using copperoxychloride 0.5%. Next, the plague or the twig. The cause of this disease is the rotting of some of the plant's roots so that it interferes with the uptake of nutrients from the soil. Usually this disease occurs in the plant's age 5 years and over that have produced flower, especially trees that grow close to the surface of the water. The symptoms that appear are the leaves on some branches change color from yellowish to yellowish and will eventually fall out, followed by the teeth and the branch. Plants stay alive, but some of the branch die. the way to deal with this disease is that because the cause of this disease is the physiological factor, environmental conditions, it's better if the soil around the plant's canopy should be loosened immediately outside the plant's canopy ventilation holes. Apply fertilizer properly and improve drainage around the plant. Next.
Okay, the next is algae disease. The disease is caused by the algae Cephalorus mucosa. The attack is focused on the leaves from the young leaves in the nursery until the plant is young after being planted in the field.
Just in the front and around the leaf, there are small red spots, while in the middle of the leaf, there are yellowish white spots. Violent attacks can drop the leaf so that the branch look as if they are dead. This situation arises because of a lack of shade, or it can also be due to a lack of nutrients. Prevention of this disease can be done by providing good protection or shade. If the shade is not good, usually during the dry season, the plants will suffer a lot because they cannot stand the hot sun. So besides good shade, do watering properly according to the plant's need. Next.
The conclusion of this is control of coffee and clove plants. The conclusion is coffee plants are the host of various diseases like coffee leaf rust, coffee leaf spot, fungus disease, and coffee root disease. The obstacle that are often encountered in clove cultivation is that can result in disrupted plant growth, decreased production, and even a death of plants. One type of disease that attacks a plant and is often encountered are root rot disease. Are for control this commonly used of variety. Second one is biological control use. Ways and let us discuss and inspire. Thank you. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.